Hey, this is Overpass Insights. My name is Eric and I make apps. Now today I want to give my advice for becoming an Android developer in 2019. All right, so today I want to answer a question that came in last weekend from Roberto. I think this came in on Easter Sunday. So Roberto says, "Hi, I started an MSc in software engineering after changing career from nursing. I think that was a good move. Nothing against nurses, but I think that sounds really challenging and really difficult. I think being a software developer, to me, sounds like it would be a bit more fun. I couldn't imagine being in the nursing field, but I follow your videos since 1 year ago. I learned Java and OOP and I'm gonna buy an Android book. I would like to ask your suggestions in order to become a successful Android developer and open my own business in the future. What would you suggest your son if he wanted to start his career in Android development? Is it possible to generate income starting from zero in 2019? Thank you from your time, Roberto." All right, good question. So starting from zero, is it possible to make revenue or to make income? Yeah, definitely. I genuinely believe that, right? Software development is different than other professions because we're able to take something that doesn't exist and create it out of thin air. And the problem you have is whether or not you can get people to pay for it. As to what kind of advice I would give to my kids, first of all, I have three kids and they're all going into their own things and none of them are interested in going into software development. As much as I try to make it look cool, they're just not interested. But a lot of the times, the advice is still the same regardless of what they go into. The question you ask saying, is it still possible to do it in 2019? I think the assumption there is that it's too crowded, it's too difficult. Like it used to be, if you were gonna start, you should have started 5 years ago when it was easier. You should have started 10 years ago when it was easier, right? But that's not an option, right? And most other professions, we don't have that feeling that it used to be easier than it is now, or it's that this is easy to do, or this is just free money that people hand out. It's a job like any other, and you have to get really, really good at it, right? And there's different ways you can go as an Android developer, right? You can release your own applications, put stuff on the Play Store, which you should be doing anyway, right? Even on your spare time, I think everybody should be, if you're an Android developer, you should be putting out apps regularly, even if they're not perfect, even if they're not great. It's just you're putting the reps in, you're getting really good at it. So there's two ways you can go. You can either go that way or you could go get a job for somebody. And sometimes getting a job for somebody is a really good way to learn how to get better at that craft, right? And as more and more Android developers, you know, they get skilled up and they become Android developers, then there are too many apps going to the Play Store. There are too many people looking for those Android jobs. But that always happens. Every time something, you get this, "Oh, this is easy money. I'm just going to take a course and I'm going to become an expert at this." Everybody does it, and all you have to do is be better than the rest of them. I mean, many times in my career, we've seen this kind of stuff. I mean, in the early 2000s, I can remember when everybody became an HTML developer, right? And everybody became a web developer. And then we had the bubble burst, and then the economy went funny, and then everyone got back to their senses, and a lot of people, they just fell off the map. They stopped being web developers. They went on to do their other jobs, right? And it was only the people who were either really good at what they did or more dedicated and really just hanging on there that were able to keep it. And every so often we get that, where we get this thing where supply outweighs demand. And when that happens, when we have too many Android developers, what happens is a lot of them fall by the wayside. If you take a look at the Play Store, I meet a lot of people who said, "Oh yeah, I released an Android app 5 years ago. I never even updated it. Nobody downloaded it. I just sort of stopped doing it." It's there, right? The only reason it's still on the Play Store is because it's there forever. It's not like iOS where they have to renew it every year. They just leave it on there. So that's why it's so crowded. So what I'm trying to say, Roberto, if I was gonna give my kids any advice is, get really, really good at doing it, right? Get really good at doing it rather than thinking about the money. If you get really good at doing it, the money will be fine. You'll be able to get a job doing it, or you'll be able to produce something that's really good. Earlier this week, I gave a talk to students at a school in Oxford. It was pretty cool. We were talking a bit about app development, but then also talked a little bit about YouTube and stuff. And I was talking to a young lady who writes a blog, right? And she was saying, She was asking me, when you started your YouTube videos and nobody was watching, how did you keep going? Because she was having this problem with her blog. She's blogging and nobody's reading it and she's getting discouraged. And my whole thing was, at some point you're gonna get this huge idea. You're gonna get this really great concept and you're gonna be able to fly with it. You're gonna find your voice. You're gonna be able to what you need to do. But the way to get that is to keep writing, right? The last thing you want as an Android developer or as any kind of software developer, the last thing you want is for you to get this spark of inspiration, this great idea, the idea that really makes it go for you, and you're not prepared for it because you haven't learned how to code yet. You haven't learned how to do what you need to do yet, right? Get really, really good at it. Be prolific. Start putting stuff out there. If you're not putting stuff out there for yourself, do stuff for other people. Get some clients. I mean, a lot of the stuff I learned, I'm doing for clients. So it's just a client comes in and we're able to get really, really good at it and just putting the reps in and get, and you know, when I get that big idea, the next big idea I get, I'm going to be ready to pounce on it. We're going to be able to release it because we know how to do it, right? Anyway, that's just my advice for you. Roberto, don't get discouraged. Don't let anybody talk you out of doing this. It's a good profession. There's going to be plenty of work out there. If you get a job working for somebody, if you need to, that could be the fallback, even though the goal is doing your own company, doing your own apps, all that kind of stuff, right? Because that's my goal too, right? But you know, if I had to, if all of this collapsed around me, I'd be standing in that, my CV would be out on the market again. I have no question in my mind about that. So the rest of you guys out there who want to offer a Roberto some advice, please do. I know I have these little rants every so often, but I genuinely believe that, yeah, you can start from zero. Software development is that we create something from nothing. We look at a blank code window and we create something. How many other professions can you say that from? So anyway, that is it for today, this week, whatever, the new format. Anyway, I'll talk to you next time. Bye.